My name is Mark Dubiel, and I am a co-owner of Encinitas Wine Merchants, located in Encinitas. Moved to San Diego in 1975 from Detroit. My background was accounting, and it was hard finding a job, so I took a job running a prominent wine retail store and fell in love with it. I was on the original Wine Spectator tasting panel. There was a gentleman by the name of Robert Morrissey who owned the original Wine Spectator before he sold it. He wrote an article in the late 70s about the wine boom that was going to happen. If I had to put a real date on it, I would probably say 1979.
My name is Arabella.
Oh, my name is Jesse.
We went to a hotel school, and one of our classes was tasting wines and learning how to taste wines.
More of a beer guy.
My name is Casey Rawlings.
And my name is Adam Rawlings.
So we're newlyweds, what, just a couple of months now?
2 months.
I guess I'm more the wine drinker than he is. I started out with the white Zinfandels, really sweet, to the Chardonnays, and now I'm hooked on reds, and now I recently just went back to white, so I like all sorts of wines, and I'm not a very picky wine drinker, I guess, but I don't like the super cheap ones, I do know that.
My experience with wine is usually driving her home. The wines that I do like are usually your drier type red wines.
My name's Jesse. I live in this house. I'm Jen's boyfriend, and I brought a bottle of wine. I've drank wine for years, but never really knowing much about the wine that I'm drinking. Just kind of when it tastes good, it tastes good, and when it doesn't, I guess.
My name is Angie.
And my name is Austin.
And this is Harley.
I guess I've been drinking wine for 5 years, maybe, I guess, something.
Okay. You're a Keystone kind of guy.
And yeah, definitely Keystone was number one on the list. No, but I really enjoy red wines for the most part.
My mom is Basque, so she started boozing me up at about 5. No, we had wine with dinner. I think it was watered down every night, but it was table wine by Gallo, so my palate is very sophisticated. She's a year and a half, she doesn't drink wine yet. We're hoping to introduce her the next year or so.
The wine that we brought tonight is a Chateau Neuf du Pape. It is self the Orliflamme.
We have the Benzinger Merlot.
I brought Juan Gil. It's from Spain.
Okay, this is Goat Roddy from South Africa.
There's very few places in the world that produce world-class wines. You probably grow vines on Mars, but world-class Appellation. Napa's a world-class Appellation. Burgundy's a world-class Appellation. The Champagne region, Tuscany in Italy, these are, but there's a lot of areas that are not. Red, red
wine. And it's an Appellation, Chateau Neuf du Pape, Contrôlé.
That's such a big word, Appellation. I usually...
It's from the Jumila.
It's kind of been a family favorite, so that's why I chose it.
I've never enjoyed a wine that was a screw top either.
I have.
I do think it's going to be the big winner. Because of this recommendation from the wine merchant, I think I have a leg up over these buffoons.
I'm expecting it to be a good wine.
A Chateau Neuf du Pape, Réserve de Orliflamme.
You have to remember one thing, and it's real simple, is that all it is squished grapes. And despite what anybody will tell you, it's the most important component that determines whether a wine is average, good, very good, or world class. Stay close.